Welcome back to my channel. Well, it's time to talk about our game winners here. I haven't had no problems with this until this year. My motor went out on it. So I want to talk to you a little bit more before I get to the motor and how we're going to fix that. I buy game winners. They're inexpensive. They're at Academy. I don't feel like spending hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of dollars on bigger feeders that are probably better. These have a problem where the corn doesn't funnel all the way down through the feeder. So as it gets towards the end or the bottom here, you got to kind of push it towards the hole. That's one of the downfalls about the feeder. But what we're going to do now is I got to take off the varmint cage, which is a simple 10 millimeter wrench. Okay, so bear with me on this as we take it off and drop it so I can get the motor out of the way, because that's what we're going to replace, is the motor, because I had a short. The only thing I can think of is the motor. So to do it, we're going to take it apart. And I don't think there's a video ever out there that I've seen that ever taught me how to do that. So let me take this off and we'll get started. All right, as you can see, I got my little varmint cage off. I got four screws. Now, what I'm gonna do with the screws, I'm just gonna put them back in the holes so I don't lose them, okay? I don't think the squirrel's gonna steal them. And I'm just gonna set this on the ground and leave it down here until I fix my thing. I don't need to carry this around everywhere. But I just wanted to show you that it is easy. Not a piece of... just a little couple screws in the holes, and then we're gonna talk about what we're gonna do here next. All right, I got my bolts in there. So, bought a pair of pliers. These have got wing nuts. They're just wing nuts that hold this box up here, by the way. We'll take them all the way off, because we don't need them at this point in time. We're gonna slide this box off and take it back up to the house and replace the wing nut came off and nothing else came off with it. Oh well, I guess I gotta get to the inside of that box and take that out too, huh? So we'll find out here in a second. First time ever taking it apart. I've always put them together. Well, we're gonna let it rain corn until I can figure out what to do here. Looks like I got another wrench I gotta get in there and take them bolts off, huh? Scratch that idea. We gotta take the top fins off. That's not gonna be fun. Well, ladies and gentlemen, it looks like I gotta take the top piece off over here so I can get the thing out. So I'll get right back with you, so hold on. What I want to do now is I'm going to show you underneath this thing here with the camera real quick and show you what I took off, and you guys get a better idea. Okay, hold on. All right. All I did was just loosen up the screws on this one right here, took it off, pulled it out, and got my thing out here. The corn actually falls through here, and you can see the other holes that are holding on the feeder stuff right here like that. This is for the hole that goes up for my solar power, and the nuts right here to the side. Let me go down this side right here. That holds on the critter relief, okay? So what we're going to do is fix this box right here. As you can see, it really wasn't hard to take the motor off down here, take it back up there. Now, the other motors are just about the same. They're just four bolts that hold on the actual box to the bottom of these things and your varmint cage, of course. And then you take it out and you take it to the garage or your workbench, wherever you want to do it, and test it and play with the motor. So that's step one. Step two, I hope I got the other motor. I think I still got a motor up there. So we'll do that next, and we'll take you along with me. Thank you. Hey, before I go, I want to show you the problem that Game Winner has with the corn and why I do what I do coming out here. When I check my camera cards, I make sure the corn's in the middle. Hold. See what I mean? The corn does not, you have to kind of push it towards this middle. It doesn't flow down properly. So your corn, you'll still have a lot of corn here, but your feeder will stop working. So don't think it's a feeder. It's the corn in the feeder that's having a problem with it, as you can see. So what I have to do is clean it all out, because I'm not going to put any more corn in here this year, because game wardens don't allow it. No, it's illegal to feed deer, turkey during hunting season. I disagree with them laws. Kentucky does it. They put corn out there. Other states do it, and they have no problem. You got to manage the deer. To manage the deer, you got to get them in here. They're getting out there hit by cars. I see at least 10 deer every day hit by cars, and that's insurance money. I wish the state would change the law and allow us to feed all year round so that animals will come in. You get a decent shot at them, but, you know, it is Tennessee law. I learned my lesson last time. The critters never touched this corn for 12 to 14 days, and then I got caught on the 14th day. And I didn't know. I said 10 days. And y'all know the laws, and we all been down that road already. So my suspension's lifted. I don't plan to go back on it. So there's no going to be no battery in here, no corn. Ain't going to be anything anywhere in this area. Other than the salt blocks, okay, and a mineral block. So we'll be good to go there. Those are legal. So in the meantime, let's go fix this motor. It doesn't look like the motor's bad. It looks like it just needs to be lubed on top. So we're gonna find out. Well, I brought the feeder up here, took the top part off, which is a spinner blade, okay? Now, I thought the motor was burned out. Come to find out, the motor is still good. I just tested it out here at the table with my battery charged. So what the problem was, this thing got a little dirty and cruddy, so it didn't spin. So what we're going to do now is I'm going to hook it back up, and I'll show you that it spins, and it was a quick fix, and see what happens. Put it back together. Earlier, I said there's just two screws right here on the top, and that takes your whole motor off, so you can replace it. I've got a brand new motor sitting in there, but all it took was a can of WD-40, because like I said, my feeders sit out there all year round, and of course you're going to get corroded and dirty and all that other good stuff. So I just wanted to let you know that, hey, you need to go out there once in a while. We need to spray them down with WD-40. So that's exactly what I'm going to do come this year when deer end of turkey season or whatever, I get ready to start. So my timer still works. It ain't got no time on it, but I'm just going to go down here to test, push it. We got 10 seconds. Let's see what happens here. Yeah, we're counting down here. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Let's see if she spins. There you go, ladies and gentlemen. Quick fix. Wasn't nothing major. All it was is put a little WD-40 on the motor around the top portion of it so you can let it spin freely. It gets gummed up. That's the way it is. But like I said, you take this little spinner piece off, there's two little screws on the bottom, and your motor comes out. That's how easy this thing is. So I hope this video helps you, like it helped me, understand what's going on with these feeders. And all three of my feeders are the same way. They've got a box that holds the battery, with the exception of my wife's, which I've never had a problem day one, because it's only got a gap like this, and the feeder is like way up in here, so they get water, junk in there, it's not gonna do. So my next video, I'm gonna modify it so the corn flows freely down in there. Will I get the whole 3 40-pound bags in there? I doubt it. I never put more than two bags in my feeders anyway. But the bottom line is I'm going to take some metal, like you do around a chimney or something, put it down there, kind of bend it out, bolt it together, and the corn just falls straight down to the bottom. I'm going to make a funnel of some sort. But let me work on that project, and I'll get back with you next. Well, we're done. The feeder's back together. It's operational and all that good stuff there. So ladies and gentlemen, if you like this channel, please give me a like down there in the bottom of my right, a subscribe and a notification, and you get all my videos, and I do appreciate it. To all my subscribers and my new subscribers, welcome, and let's look forward to a good season of 2023. Thank you.